Vikings really love fighting, but did you know that some Viking warriors were so famous that we even remember the names today?
Welcome to the Mass Viking, which is currently in York.
Today we are pleased to be joined here by three famous Viking warriors hidden behind their masks.
Bring on the panel.
Let me introduce Sniper Wolf, Rowan Atkinson, and Gordon Ramsay.
Welcome, our first Mass Viking. Bring on the monk.
I think it could be Eric the Red.
From the way he handled that axe, I reckon it's Leif Erikson.
I know this is a bit of a guess, but could it be Simon Cowell? We all know how mean he is.
Well, we'll just have to wait till later to find out.
Bring on the next contestant! And another monk! Ragnar Lothbrok.
I think it could be Chris Pratt, because he's always playing around.
I think it's The Rock, because he's very tall and strong.
Interesting guesses. Let's bring our third and last Mass Viking. And another monk. The mask.
Charlie.
I think it could be Ivar the Boneless. We all know how athletic he is.
I think it's Sigurd Andersson. Can you see that mark on his eye?
I know it's a bit out there, but I think it could be David Attenborough.
David Attenborough? Are you kidding me?
Now it's time to see who the audience would want to keep.
And who the audience wants to unmask.
Viking 1 and 2! Viking 1 and 2! Viking 1 and 2!
Congratulations, you get to fight another day.
So unfortunately, that means that Viking 3 is in last place, so that means you'll need to take off your mask.
Take it off! Take it off! Take it off! Take it off!
It's the vicious Viking warrior Ragnar Lothbrok. It looks like you're not as mighty as you thought you were.
Thank you for watching The Mass Viking.
We have a little problem to fix, but we'll see you soon. Bye!
Viking warriors really did use a range of weapons, including axes, swords and spears. They also killed a lot of innocent monks.
Did you know Vikings practiced wrestling to sharpen up their battle skills in hand-to-hand combat? Over time it became a popular form of entertainment.
We'll be right back.
the match of the day. Today we'll be looking at the results after the game Niffertafel and wrestling. Let's pass it over to Herbie, who is witnessing the season's last game.
Thank you, James. And this is the biggest game of the season. Whoever wins is the chess champion. If you come over here, you can see that the competition is high. The first move has stumped Eric. Let's go over to some of the fans and see what their predictions are. You there, who do you think is going to be the winner?
Well, I think Gunnar is going to absolutely smash Eric and win the CC.
And why do you think that?
Well, it's simply because Gunnar has years of experience and Eric only has a month's worth.
This game is 8 to 9 centuries old and it looks like the game was finished and Gunnar is the winner. Let's go over to the champion. Sir, how do you feel about winning the CC?
I know with joy that I could defeat my opponent and win the CC.
Well, that's the end of the game of Niffertafel. Let's go back over to James.
Why, thank you, Herbie. I've just gotten a word from the wrestling arena that the match is about to start soon. Let's go over there and see how this tremendous competition is going to turn out.
Thank you. Anyway, let me tell you the history of Viking wrestling while we make our way to the ring. The Vikings practice wrestling to sharpen up their battle skills in hand-to-hand combat. Over time, this has become a source of entertainment and pleasure to fight. Three forms of Viking wrestling are practiced. There is wrist grip, arm and unarmed self-defense, and back grip. Well, Sif has made an excellent start, so it looks like Vlad is going to make a comeback.
And the Viking champion is the one and only Bladder!
Yes! Yes!
Let's speak to Bladder about this amazing comeback.
Actually, it's Boulder. I cannot believe I have won this. I thought I would get pushed to the ground straight away, but it turns out I have more agility than...
Thank you. Now over to James.
That's it for... That's it for today! Bye!
It's true, Vikings enjoyed a form of chess called Niffertafel. It was an old violence in rage.
No, thank you.
You will, my slave.
Hey, slave, are you Christian?
Yeah.
Oh. No, Christian. Stop!
I was going to trade him to the reporter.
Never mind. I've got it.
Well, at least we got a free slave.
Do I have to pay you?
You never pay a slave.
I heard you silver.
No, gold.
But I don't have any silver or gold.
That's okay. We'll just take your leg instead.
Yeah.
Vicious Vikings!
We are your hosts for today and over every episode of
I'm a Viking, get me out here in Norway.
So let's meet our contestants.
I am Inga, I am super crazy.
No, it's kill.
I dick.
Hold your horse, pal. Let's get to know each other first.
Okay.
I'm Inga and I am an independent woman who gets everything other than food and killing.
Well, there's no time to lose, Viking.
So let's get on with our first trial.
Yippee!
Just get on with it.
Your first trial is, well, it's a punishment for your very worst enemy. You have to tear out a victim's spine and lungs and pull out the bones from their skin.
That's true. Vikings really did do this.
Ooh!
Ew, that's gross. I'm not doing that.
I'll do it then, you big wimp.
Well, just watch out for tomorrow's trial. I can't believe the goddess Hel made us do this. Or maybe it was Thor.
Well, he is the god of thunder.
It's raining.
My goddess. Then, did you guess it?
Oh yeah.
Are you done yet? Because I am.
No, it's too gross.
Let's... Sorry, we got a bit distracted. And we weren't watching, so... Could you do it again?
Please!
Right, Raggy. You may start on the sound of the bones cracking.
Okay, I'm fine with that.
Back to camp.
Because you did scary well in your first trial, you get 1.5 star dinner.
This is disgusting. They're gonna absolutely hate it.
I know, it's gross, isn't it?
The drink you have,
I didn't
know. A sour milk like yogurt, I guess.
And your meal is a goat's leg.
Don't worry, it's really spicy, so they won't notice though it's a bit rotten.
With eggs, bread and...
tree bark!
It sounds delicious! I'll wait to try it.
Well, that was a surprise. I know, I thought it was going to be another horrible task. Well, thanks for watching.
Let's kill Anthony there, that's a good idea.
True or false? Viking currency was called Peninga.
It's true.
Nothing beats a Viking longship holiday. Book now for just a 6 Peninga deposit per person and spread the cost with flexible monthly payments. On a longship holiday, you can slaughter monks and steal their gold. Longship holidays, a package you can trust. Longship holidays, a package you can trust.
Did you know that Vikings travelled to many places around the world, including England, Scotland, France, and many other countries?
Horrible histories!
Thank you.
our Viking leader.
Ah!
Okay. And finally, boring modern-day human, Bella.
Hello.
What are you baking today?
Fresh bread with steak and a side of salad.
What is going on here?
We smash bread to our toe.
Bread sounds nice. What are you having with it?
Seagulls.
Ew, lovely.
Walrus and eel.
Ew. 5 minutes left.
Oh no, I'm nowhere near finished.
1 minute remaining. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Step away from your bread.
1 more hour.
No. Okay, 1 more hour remaining. For the final time, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time to try the food. No soggy bottoms here. It looks disgusting. I mean, too good to eat, I think. I think it's time to announce the winner. And the winner is Belle. I mean, Erra, and Ragnar.
Let's celebrate.
Yes,
I'm
dying.
Hello and welcome to Foreign Event Viking Edition. Today we'll have four different couples, each sharing their beds and breakfast. They will go around each property one by one and reviewing them carefully. Now it's time to meet our couples. John and Sarah own a boutique hotel in Chesterfield.
Hello.
Next, Andrew and Margot run a traditional B&B by the coast in North Wales.
Hello.
Our third couple are Ron and Emma, who own a high-class spa hotel in Sheffield.
Hello.
Hello.
Unfortunately, our final couple had to pull out at the last minute, but we have found a replacement. Frodo and Frida, who have a cosy dwelling in the woods. Sorry, we were speaking out loud.
Can you speak English, please?
This isn't awkward at all. Yesterday, Andy and Margot hosted, they were disappointed by the feedback from Ron and Emma, who found dust on the windowsill and hair in the shower. Today, Frodo and Frey will be welcoming guests. Ron and Emma are first to arrive.
Where's the B&B?
Well, it's here, silly.
Can you show us around?
Yes, of course.
Oh no, what have we got ourselves into?
Looks like the next couple have arrived.
Oh no, what have we got ourselves into?
Looks like someone's woke up on the wrong side of the bed.
Quick hide before he sees us.
Oh, hello Andy and Margot. Our house is up here, not down there.
Looks like John and Sarah have arrived.
Wow guys, great joke. Where is the house?
What do you mean? This is the real house.
But really, where is the house?
I'm not lying. I'll your tour of your room if you like.
Oh, we would love to.
For some reason, I don't think this is a good idea.
This is your room. It costs £1.50 per night.
That's definitely cheaper than our place. Oh my goodness, this is a disgrace.
Wow, but look, over here, the toilets are whole. Up and down.
There's no way that's the toilet.
Ron and Emma, this is your room. It costs £2 a night.
£200 a night?
No, £2, silly. Anyway, have a look around.
Oh my god,
there's so much room and no flooring.
Emma, don't be so bitter. This is the last hour of a Viking. We could do with some adventure in our lives. This is your room. It'll cost £1.50 a night. Bye.
Sarah, look at the ensuite. It's hideous.
You can't even call it a shower room.
The roof is made of straw.
Anyway, let's go meet up with the other couple.
Morning everyone! How did everyone sleep?
Not the best, but I enjoyed the experience.
Same, but my back hurts.
I don't get how you people can survive here. I got woken up 5 times last night by those animals.
Well, it seems that you all didn't have the best of nights, but I'm sure that breakfast will make up for it.
Yes, I'm starving.
First on the menu is fermented shark which is made by cutting off a head of a shark. Burying it, let it sit, and then cut a slice off to eat.
Are you serious? I thought I was going to get a decent meal.
Come on, Margot, get into the spirit.
Ron, how could you even sleep in that bed?
Moving on, the next dish is fish soup and fish bread.
Who wants what?
Me and Emma will give fermented shark a try.
Margo and I will be eating this morning, thank you.
Come on, guys. Into the spirit.
No, we won't be eating. That's final.
Me and Sarah will be having fish soup and fish bread.
Sarah and John, your food.
Emma and Ron, your food.
And even though you guys said you didn't want anything, I brought you fresh oysters.
They're kind of fresh. We found them 2 weeks ago along the coast of Viking Bay. It's a special recipe, give it a try.
You think I need to eat it? You're wrong.
Come on, Margo, give it a try, you might like it.
I'm not eating that monstrosity.
If you won't eat it, I will.
Fine, I'll eat it.
I'm guessing that's a no.
Well, at least you tried it.
Let's move on to the reviews.
I think we should give it an 8 out of 10.
To be honest, I don't think it deserves a rating, but because I have it hot, I say we should give it a 1 out of 10 and a full 30p.
We will give it a 6 out of 10.
And we'll pay full price.
Thank you all for coming. Altogether, we made £3.80.
I don't think that could have gone better.
It's true, the Vikings did really eat fermented shark.
Vicious Vikings!
Did you know that Vikings didn't have a particularly varied diet? I mean, they ate eggs and vegetables, but they mostly ate meat.
Did somebody say just
meat?
Meat. Get NFC like Loki. See hungry pigs got a feast. I get mine every day, every week, chicken chunks to the place I'm sitting in. Burger in the low, help to keep the chicken in. Pork chops to the long shit. Sweet meat like horse meat. Mutton to the venue, please.
Did somebody say just
please?
Long ship in the blue sea. My man handside by with my cut beef. What can you not love about goat on the side of the boat? What you gonna do, boo? Fermented shark right on cue. Even looking at the view, I see fruit, just meat, sees me, J-U-S-T.
Did somebody say just
meat?
Yes, it's true, Vikings ate meat, lots of meat.
To the chase. Let's see if these contestants can beat the Viking. Firstly, let me introduce the contestants. Jetchi, the captain, Monk, Shenzhou, and Daphne. And lastly, Eric, the chaser.
If I win, I get to keep you all as my slaves in my house.
You don't know how good we are, Eric.
The first question is, when did the Vikings invade Lindisfarne? A. 797 AD, B. 793 AD, or C. 789 AD?
I really don't know this, but I think it's A.
Is it correct? No, the chaser has put B, which is correct. Well done to the Viking.
Yes!
Alright, next question. How many gods do monks have in Christianity? A, 1, B, 200, or C, 30?
I know this. A, obviously. I'm Christian after all.
The correct answer is A, and Eric has put B.
Impossible. That is incorrect. B is the correct answer.
I'm sorry, but B is incorrect.
Ha ha ha, you got it wrong.
Shinzu is going to step up. Did Vikings have horns on their helmets? A, yes. B, no. Or C, sometimes.
It's obviously B. I'm not stupid.
Is the answer correct? Yes, and the chaser said. I'm gonna need an answer, Eric. That is incorrect. The monks are the winners!
Hooray! Thank you, Morgan!
Why don't we end the chase with a natural chase?
Did you know that in Viking times, 16 chickens would have cost 1 penny? What a bargain! Speaking of bargains.
Of Bargain Hunt. Today we'll be accompanied by my fellow presenter Amy and two vicious Viking warriors, Beau and what's your name again?
Thorbjörn.
Ah yes, today we are joined by Beau and Thorbjörn, two vicious Viking warriors.
Thorbjörn.
My apologies, I ensure it doesn't happen again.
Let the bargain hunt begin!
So far, Bowty, what deal have we secured here?
Me trading for treasure.
Ah, far, Bowty, well, has deal been secured?
So far, Bowty, where to next?
Market. Well, we'll see you at the market then.
Now, though, what more are we doing here?
Me found bargain.
We'll put you back. Hello, Fabalti.
Hello, I come here for marriage.
Me marry me you?
No, you marry daughter.
You marry daughter?
No, you marry daughter.
Okay. You know this man, Fabalti?
Yes, my son works here. Hello, son.
Hello.
If I give daughter for marriage, you give jewels.
What's happening?
What? No, you can't trade me. I'm your daughter. I can marry whoever I want. Trade her into a thrall instead.
Yes, daughter is right, not the place to be.
You can't trade me. I don't belong to you. Jeremy, do something!
The girl will do for thrall.
Well, let's find out who has the bargain.
Me have jewels.
Me have chicken.
not get jewels. Deal?
Deal.
The vicious Vikings really did fight over everything.
We did not!